Okay. We're gonna hope that this glare doesn't affect too much. I'm gonna try to explain the branded waterfall approach to Google Plus for sharing news or other information resources. I think this is a really interesting way to approach it, opposed to having the news or the branded sites like the other G Plus profiles that the users have. So let's explain this. So basically what this is the news waterfall. And instead of having one stream of news stories, what you have is a wall like Sparks. When you go to Sparks, you see a wall of like two rows of four, two rows of six, and you have your topics that you choose from. But when you click that, it takes you to a single line, it's a single stream. It's continuously updated with the things that you're looking for. What I'd like to have is a news brand waterfall, where it's a lot of streams coming through at the same time, but it's all coming through in the same place. So you'd have your titles, tech, science, politics, world, whatever. You have your news sources. These could be TechCrunch, MSNBC, CNN, Fox News, Mashable, any of the big names that are branded our news sources. And you'll see these here next to the abstract of whatever news information that they're sharing at that time. This section continuously updates all of these news story topics, continually bumped down. Each time one of these news sources or each time one of these brands streams out a news story. So when they stream it out, instead of it going to their circles or the people that they have in their circle, it streams out to this main board where people go for the news or go for the brands that they want to see. And this is good because rather than me watching, rather than me adding, let's say, CNN to one of my circles, then when I click on the news circle, I'll have whatever stories that CNN keeps feeding out. That's great, but if I make a circle of 50 news brands, it's kind of complicating my stream because it's just going to fill up my stream with all of this news that's unfiltered. So I'm not going to know which news stories have the right perspective, which news stories are biased, and I'm going to have to go through and pick through this. So why don't we crowdsource the ranking, just like dig in a certain way. What we'll have is the waterfall setup, the main page that you look at, the news story. When you click on one of these, it'll take you to the news story that they're sharing. However, these brands get ranked, so when a Google user shares this story, the news source that originally shared that gets a point. I haven't worked out the algorithms for how the rankings will work, but I do know a majority of the variables that I want to add into it. So let's say, let's just stick with CNN for the sake of this. Let's say CNN shares a story in the science section, and I find that story to be really interesting. So I take that story and I share it out to my circles. So CNN gets a plus one or whatever value, plus X, because I shared it. Each time that shares, they'll continue to get increased rank. But it's not plus one for each one. You can set up a completely different algorithm for how deeply it gets shared. So if this is CNN and this is me, and then I share it out to three circles, and then those circles, each person shares it out for three. What you want to do is rank your news sources based on how deep they get in the network. How many, including not just how deep they get in the network, but in addition to that, each time the story is plus one, it throws it onto the ring. So what happens is you'll have these news brands feeding out their information into this waterfall that you can sort of pick through. But when the news source is ranked higher based on how far it shares into the network, how many plus ones it gets, these news sources will then be ranked higher, and they'll stay in the feed longer, or maybe there'll be a certain section where their news stories show up more often. But basically, it creates a sort of accountability, because if I find a news story from CNN to be really great, but the majority of the population on Google Plus doesn't share any news stories from CNN, I'm going to find that it's probably not a very reliable source if there's not a lot of other people that are taking interest in the stories that they're sharing. These brands can continue to share into the waterfall. However, when you do that, you're risking diluting your popularity. Because if no one shares your stories that you submit, that should count against you for sharing crap stories, right? So for the algorithm that will boost your ranking, if you flood the waterfall just so that you can sort of overwhelm the system and maybe game it, that affects you in a negative way. So it sort of deters against that. This can also be incorporated in with the Google News badges, so that the users that then take these stories and share them on, if the users that are passing them on have increased badges for the amount of stories that they've read in Google News, then that'll increase the point value that the news sources get. Power users, you have like Scoble, and you have Kevin Rose and Leo Port that have, you know, thousands of followers on G+. Certainly they could just go to this and pick a story and it would hit 7,000 people. However, I want to eliminate the ability for power users to affect the rankings. I want them to still be able to share, but I don't want that initial share to count into the rankings for the news source. I think that if this is a power user and they share, if they share into one circle and then that circle shares out, it should really start with, if a power user shares with me, I see it, and then I take it and I share, it starts with me. So the getting to me is sort of a bonus, because they can get out, but I still have to reshare the story in order for it to get any sort of additional rank. And I think that's about it. I mean, I think it would be really great if you came into a screen and they were just constantly updating stories that were coming down this waterfall. See, sort of follows a stream idea, where the streams would all converge into this waterfall. And then we pick out what we want, and based on what we pick out, those sources are then raised up as being the sources that are providing information that people want. And the sources that maybe only share once in a while, that are ranked well, that receive, you know, a good buzz from whatever they're sharing, when they submit anything to the waterfall again, they'll have higher priority, because whatever they had shared was well received. I think that's about it. I think this sort of setup is a lot like how Twitter's analytics are set up. So you can sort of map how far and how much and how many retweets and how quickly things spread out over the network. I think if we incorporated that in with the news and the branding, we could definitely track who were reliable sources and who was sources that are irrelevant. And then we would filter that out. We wouldn't have to follow those people anymore. We wouldn't need our streams flooded with all of this information that we picked through. The Google Plus population helps filter out the news. And it's not just based on plus ones, so that would be sort of more along the dig lines, where you dig a story if you like it, this would be all behind the scenes based on how quickly and how far it spreads out across the network. And then that would feed back into the ranking system of when the stories are fed into the waterfall. So that's it. That's the G+ news brand waterfall.